It's just, you know, come on, I've eaten a crap sandwich out here. I don't give a damn what you people.
That's the problem, bitch. That's the problem. You don't give a damn. And my problem is I care too much. Am I a bad guy? Absolutely. I don't wear a white hat, but I damn sure am in touch with what these people want. And right now, I think Boston wants to hear an apology.
Sorry. Got it? I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. What?
I said I'm sorry.
What?
If there's ever an appropriate time. What?
I apologize, you son of a bitch.
Just apologize to CM Punk.
Yeah, pick it up and sign it before the stock plummets some more.
Fine speech. Listen to them, man. They love you. And they'll love you in your hometown of Chicago. And that's the night you walk out on each and every one of them. You want to sign that? You want to cave into a terrorist? I'm not going to tell you what to do. Last week, I asked you for a match. A match that you earned and a match that you want to see, and I think that's worth standing up for. But right now, you guys are like a bunch of kids, a bunch of spoiled brats. Yeah, I want this. Yeah, I want that. Yeah, I have this. Yeah, I have that. Yeah, I like this. Yeah, I like that. Would you sigh? Look at you. Look at you. I get it. You feel mistreated at work, and you hate this guy. I hate him, too. You know how many days I walk into a WWE locker room and want to rip his face off with my bare hands? And make it into a cute little floor mat, you know, something classy you can get at Bed Bath & Beyond. And then go out and step in crap and take my crappy shoes and wipe them on that floor mat that I just made out of his face. And then have my dog come in and pee on that floor mat that crap's just been wiped on and flush it down the toilet. That's how much I hate this guy. But I show up for work every day. Because if we have a disagreement, when we don't see eye to eye, if I don't show up, sure, it short-sides him. But these people paid a lot of good money to be here tonight. And they're the ones who really take it on the chin. These people right here, these people watching at home, you talk about hypocrites. Punk, you're the biggest hypocrite of them all. You will ask these folks if they want to see an apology. You will ask these folks to be the voice of the voiceless, and then you will leave. There is a man who stepped in this ring not too long ago and said finally he was home.
Don't even go there.
And that he was never leaving again. Easy, Dragon Breath. My God, what is he, Bigfoot Sniper? My point is, I know you're not that guy. But here you are, making a ridiculous list of demands, demands that he cannot meet. Because all you want to do is take this and walk out. Because your strongest attribute is also your biggest flaw. You are CM Punk, you beat to your own drum, and I admire that. But in the past, of doing things you want to do, you've lost sight of everything.
Oh, I'll stop you right there. I'm not going to have you sit here and belittle me and say, I've lost sight. I've lost sight of things, John. The reason I say I'm going to take that and walk out is because I don't fit a certain mold. Because I am the underdog, and that's exactly what you've lost sight of. Earlier in this ring, you mentioned great wrestlers like Eddie Guerrero, and you said that they used to look at you and think that the kid couldn't hang. And now you stand here and look at me as the kid that can't hang. John, I was hanging off of your gangster car, WrestleMania 22, as it rolled down in Chicago, Illinois, and I stood there in a suit, looking as ridiculous as that man looks right now in a suit, holding a phony Tommy gun, and I said to myself, someday, I'm not going to be standing out there watching you in the ring. I was going to be standing in the ring watching you go down to CM Punk. And now here we are in your hometown of Boston. And now next week, we'll be back there in my hometown, Chicago, Illinois. And this is the part where I talk him into the building. See, you are the one that's lost sight. And I apologize for raising my voice because I'm not that guy. But when you stand here and tell me that I've lost sight, when you, the 10-time champion who stands for hustle, loyalty, and respect, who from Boston, Massachusetts, lives and breathes these red colors, the same colors as your beloved Red Sox, who also portray themselves as the underdog. I'm sure just like the Bruins portray themselves as the underdog. Just like the Patriots think they're the underdog. Hey, how about those Celtics? Are they the underdogs too? Here's what you lost sight of, John. And I'm really happy that your father and your wife are sitting in the front row so they can hear it.
That's the last time I'm going to tell you.
What you've lost sight of is what you are. And what you are is what you hate. You're the 10-time WWE champion. You're the man. Ladies and gentlemen, the champ is here. You, like the Red Sox, like Boston, are no longer the underdog. You're a dynasty. You are what you hate. You have become the New York Yankees. Me in the face, John. I'm glad I went down this way because it hit me like a bolt of lightning exactly why I no longer want to be here, why I want to leave. It's because I'm tired of this. I'm tired of you. I'm just tired.
So ladies and gentlemen of the WWE Universe, Vince, John, Sunday night, say goodbye to the WWE title. Say goodbye to John Cena. And say goodbye to CM Punk.
I'll go be the best in the world somewhere else.